inspiration for your stories?
All over the place, but outside of comics, primarily. I'm a big fan of rock and roll poster art, you know, that has, like, again, the muscle cars and the beautiful cave woman and the sun goddess and these things sort of incorporated into, you know, wizards and just crazy stuff, like, that doesn't really make sense put together. But when you're telling a story, you have to make it make sense, you know what I mean? So those kind of visuals that just kind of cut right to the heart of things.
So do you imagine it before you have the story in your head? Do you see visuals and then you write a story to it?
Totally, yeah. I have like three, like when the first issue came out, I had three or four scenes. There's a scene with this dude with like just blood running down his forehead, and that was the visual. And like, okay, how do we get our guy from being Cody the cowboy to this madman with this blood streaming down his head running at the reader, you know? And we write into that, and you got to keep it exciting and engaging all along the way. Whenever you tell a story, I like to think it's like telling a very elaborate lie. And if you contradict yourself or anything like that, you lose the reader, and you lose the person you're quote unquote lying to, you know. So you got to keep that story going. So.
To that as well. One of my favorite things I love doing when I'm collaborating with Mikey is that he actually challenges me. According to Mike's opinion, in so many words, and not that I want to toot my own horn, he calls me the fastest artist that he's ever known, that has ever lived probably, but I don't want to even begin to even try to compare myself to the people that I love and worship that have made me the artist that I am today. But Mike always says, Ralph, can you try to do the impossible? That's basically what he asked me for a particular page. I said, why? Sure. And Mike stops and he says, wait a minute, that's just too much work for you. Maybe you shouldn't do it. And I realize, you know what? Because it is impossible, I am going to do it, and thus such things happen. It just we feed off of one another, as you can obviously see from what I've been told. We also have the power to make the women from a 10-mile radius ovulate. I don't know how that happens, but if you're feeling anything, sweetie, we do apologize.
That's amazing.
Are you ovulating?
It wasn't intentional, but there you go. But yeah, I mean, he challenges me just as much as I challenge him. So the Passovers, that we, as we're jokingly saying, we're doing it in a drunken sort of stupor. It's more like we're trying to raise the ante. You know, that's good, but you know what? It could be better. It could be great, you know? And, you know, great is even awesome, but if it becomes like immaculate, I mean, that's always what we're shooting for. You know, bet we're always working at our best, you know, no matter what we're doing.